You have a lot of hair.
I know.
I wish I had that much hair.
You can do it too. I mean,
do
I? Come from the sides.
But. People always tell me they're like, you should use Rogaine. I'm like, I do use Rogaine. Hi, I'm Burke Holland.
And I'm Sean Larkin.
And this is 5 Things About Webpack. Webpack is a module bundler,
oh,
so.
This is why we get him nice things.
Thing one, Webpack is a module bundler. So its main purpose is to bundle JavaScript files for use in a browser application, but it can do a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the main features that sets Webpack apart from anything else is that it can do a concept called code splitting. So code splitting allows you to asynchronously load your dependencies at a later time when you actually need them. So this lets you ship the minimal amount of JavaScript that you actually need, so you're not blocking the initial render of your page.
Yeah, which is a really nice technique if you have files or pages that maybe users might not use or stand a good
lazy
chance
routes.
Of using.
Yep.
Actually, I'm one of the best code splitters out there. I don't know, did you know that?
Really?
Yeah, true story. Nobody splits the code like I do.
Good to know.
Okay. Why is this plant here? It feels awkward and it's slightly off center and it's raising my anxiety level.
This a zebra aloe.
Are you sure?
I know for sure.
That sounds made up.
No, it's real.
Why do you know so much about plants?
Like it's my second like good. Like,
so just Webpack
strong
and
hobby.
Plants.
Like Webpack, woodworking, orchids, and then like general horticulture.
Where do chickens fall in that order? They're in there somewhere.
Farm animals is like in the top 6.
Really?
Yep.
Can we move it to this? Can we just move it over here? I feel better now.
Number 2, Webpack creates a dependency graph of your application. And so you might say, what is a dependency graph? Well, whenever one file relies on another, we call this a dependency. Now, when you use JavaScript modules, you create this explicit dependency that allows you to know what you're importing or exporting. So, but this goes beyond JavaScript. If you think about a CSS file and it has an image source, that image source becomes now a dependency in Webpack.
That's really interesting. So dependencies would be any time a file relies on another file, but that's not just JavaScript. That could be CSS or any other files you might be using in your application.
Absolutely.
What about codependency? I know a lot about codependency. Does it handle codependency?
We don't have support for that.
Oh, okay.
I don't think
it's too bad. That beard is serious, man. How long have you had that sucker?
Is it getting a little too gnarly on
the
side?
No, I'm saying I like it.
Honestly, it's like it took me like a full 2 years to get it to be like not homeless looking, like.
Really?
Yeah.
So it's not homeless looking now?
Well, I mean, it's a little less homeless than it used to be.
Would you be interested in a Goo Goo Cluster?
Ooh, what's this?
They're chocolate candies with caramel and peanuts. Would you like one?
Yeah, I guess. Okay. Oh no.
Yo, just take one though, because I don't have enough for everybody.
I only eat processed food, so.
Oh, you're gonna love that.
Good,
I'm gonna
okay,
have one
good.
Too, actually.
Mmm.
Yeah, this one's a supreme. What's yours?
Mmm. Standard?
Peanut butter,
yeah.
Thing number 3, loaders are what enable Webpack to do more than just JavaScript. What is a loader and how does it work?
Okay, so like the best way to describe what a loader is its anatomy. So it's just a function that takes in a source and then returns a new version of that source. Before Webpack adds a asset to the dependency graph, if it's not JavaScript, you can apply loaders to this asset to then transform it to JavaScript so that it can be bundled in your application. A good example of this is using something like CSS. The traditional way of doing it is that you would import a CSS file into your JavaScript, which seems weird, but what Webpack does is it converts it into a JavaScript module that says, take this style and then slap a script tag on the browser.
And there's a lot of loaders out there that you can just go ahead and use. I mean, we got the file loader, the URL loader, my favorite, the mermaid loader. If you
mermaid
want to
loader.
Load mermaids in what your application.
Yeah, it's, yeah, I think that's right.
Why would you do that?
I don't know.
Okay. You're wearing a Webpack shirt.
I am, do you like it?
No.
Do you want one?
No. Okay.
Oh, look at that. Thing number 4. Thing four. Plugins. Webpack plugins allow you to extend any functionality inside of the bundler itself.
So what's an example of a plugin?
So a good example is like HTML Webpack plugin. It allows you to provide a template for your index.html file. It'll automatically inject the assets for you. It'll even handle things like your Google Analytics tags and things that aren't really necessarily modules, but scripts.
Nice. You know what my favorite plugin is? The Glade plugin.
I haven't heard of that one.
It's a good one. You plug it into the wall and it makes your room smell good. I like the lavender, also the fresh laundry. It's nice. It's good stuff.
Sounds good.
Thing number five, Webpack is now there by default in things like the Angular, the React, and even the Vue CLIs. So does that mean that we are now at the day where I don't need to know anything about module bundlers and JavaScript build tools? I mean, isn't this whole interview kind of pointless?
I mean, if you don't care about web performance or you don't care about needing to scale your application or making your build system work for your workflow, no, you wouldn't. But in most cases, except every case, you do have to care about those things. So it's important to understand the tools that you're actually using so that you know how to leverage and make the best of them.
Okay, so you can care as much as you want or not care, but either way, you get to use Webpack. So
exactly.
It's good for you.
Yeah, whether you like it or not.
I'm Burke Holland.
And I'm Zach Galifianakis.
And now you know five things about Webpack.